Sparky was a little boy just about your age, or maybe a little older by now. He'd been taking piano lessons for almost a whole year and was already on his third piece. One day, Miss Spear, his piano teacher, came to his house to give him his lesson. It was on a Saturday afternoon.
That's fine, Sparky. Now play your new piece for me, The Secret. Here, I'll set the metronome.
Yes, ma'am. No, no, Sparky. Spear.
Well, not too bad for the first week. But you need more practice, Parky. Much more practice.
More practice? I've been practicing every day for a whole year, and I can't even learn a piece in a week. When will I be able to play real good? How long does it take? Sometimes I don't know whether it's worth it. I don't get outside to play as much as other kids.
Sparky, you're a good student. Don't stop your piano studies now. I wish there was some way I could show you how wonderful it is to play well. If only I could some way let you see what it's like. Well, your lesson's over. Sit down in this easy chair, and I'll put one of the records on the gramophone. The one of Igor Paduski playing the Chopin waltz in E minor. Sit down and listen, Sparky. Someday you'll be able to play like that if you keep at it. Listen to the whole thing, Sparky, and maybe you'll appreciate the piano more.
Yes, Miss Spear.
Well, goodbye, Sparky.
Goodbye. Ooh, Mr. Paduski can sure play the piano good. I wonder what it would be like to be able to play the piano like that. Oh, that sure is good. Oh. Show me what it's like to play the piano well?
Yes, Sparky. Sit down on my stool. Put your fingers on my keys.
All right. I'm sitting on the piano stool and my hands are on the keys. What do I do now?
Run your hands over my keys.
Playing, just like my teacher.
No, I'm playing for.
playing, but when I run my hands over the keys, it's just like I was playing myself. Let's play a piece. Something very hard. That revolutionary etude by Chopin. My teacher sometimes plays for me.
All right, Sparky, I'll play anything you ask me to play from now.
Oh, this is fun. No, Mother. Miss Spear has gone.
Well, who was that playing?
Well, I was, Mother.
Well, if you must have your little joke. But let's see you play like that again while I watch this time.
All right, Mother. Come on, piano. Here we go.
It really was you playing. How did you learn to play so well? Oh, I must phone your teacher right away.
I came over as fast as I could when you called. What is it? What's happened?
It's Sparky, Miss Spear. He can play the piano. He can play the piano better than I've ever heard anybody play. Better than you, his own teacher.
Now, really? Sparky is a good student, and he's getting along just fine. But as for his playing better than I, what kind of a joke is this?
Well, I know it sounds ridiculous. I couldn't believe it myself.
But it's true, Miss Spear. I can play better than you. I can play anything, anything at all. And with no music.
Well, I don't know what kind of a game this is, but go ahead and play. Let's see. Play The Flight of the Bumblebee by Rimsky-Korsakov. When I'm in practice, I can play it in a minute. If you can play it that fast now, I'd say you were the best boy pianist in the country.
I'll do it, Miss Spear. But if you can play it in a minute, I'll play it in close to half a minute.
Oh, Sparky, that's funny. No one in the world can play The Flight of the Bumblebee anywhere near half a minute. No one can play that fast. It's impossible.
Piano, can you play it that fast?
Yes, Sparky.
I will do it. Listen.
Didn't I tell you?
His hands seem to fly over the keys. They hardly seem to touch them. They go so fast. Sparky, you're the greatest pianist in the world. I don't know how it happened. It must be a miracle. Everyone must hear you play. I'll arrange a concert tour as quickly as possible.
A concert tour? You mean I'll play on the stage in front of a lot of people?
Yes, on the radio too. And with symphony orchestras. The whole world must hear you. You'll be the greatest child pianist in history.
But I can't. I can't do that.
Oh, but Sparky, I'll go with you, and Miss Spear will come along too.
Well, I'll only go if you send my own piano with me, wherever I go.
But why, Sparky? They'll have pianos better than yours wherever you play.
I won't go. I won't go unless my very own piano goes with me.
Well, let him have his way. Many pianists take their own pianos on concert tours. I suppose we can arrange it for Sparky, too.
And so Sparky's teacher went to work and arranged for his concert tour. The big music critics scoffed at the story about Sparky. They wouldn't believe that a small child could play as well as men who had studied for years and years. Sparky's first big concert was in Pittsburgh. But when the time came for him to walk out on the stage, he began to get a little nervous.
There's so many people out there. I'm scared.
Don't be frightened, dear. Your teacher and I are right here.
Go out on the stage, Sparky. Everyone's waiting.
I am. Well, here I go. Ladies and gentlemen, I shall play Chopin's Etude, Opus 10, number 4.
A very difficult piece.
But how can such a little boy play it?
After Sparky's first concert, there was never any further question as to his ability. He began to travel, and everyone was amazed that he seemed to be able to play anything without music. In Symphony Hall in Boston, he played Liszt's Hungarian Rhapsody No. 2. At the Civic Opera House in Chicago, he played Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata. Mahl in Washington, D.C., he played the Chopin Valse in C-sharp minor. So it went on until finally he reached the end of his tour and the most important concert of all. He was to play with the New York Symphony Orchestra at Carnegie Hall. By this time, Sparky was no longer frightened in front of people, and he very bravely announced to the large New York audience what he was going to play.
Ladies and gentlemen, I shall play the prelude in C-sharp minor by Rachmaninoff. For piano and orchestra.
Thank you.
Sparky, why did you walk off the stage? Go back and play an encore. They want to hear another piece.
All right, one more piece. I shall now play the spinning song by Mendelssohn.
Oh, no, you won't.
What do you mean I won't, piano?
Your time is up, I will no longer play for you.
You won't play for me anymore? Oh, please, don't stop now. Just one more piece. Please, just one more.
Sparky, play. Everyone is waiting.
Why doesn't he play? What's the matter with him?
He seems to be talking to himself.
Piano, you must play for me. You must. I've got to run my hands over the keys. Here I go. Play, play. Play, piano, play for me. Oh, it won't play. It won't play.
Sparky, play. Why can't you play? Sparky, 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 Sparky.
What? Huh? What?
Sparky, wake up, dear. You've been asleep.
Asleep? Oh, Mother, I've been dreaming. I dreamed I could play the piano better than my teacher, better than anybody. But it was just an old dream.
Don't worry, Sparky. You'll be able to play the piano well someday if you keep up your practicing.
I will. I'll practice my piece right now. And I won't give up until I can play as good as I did in my dream. Well, anyway, as good as my teacher.